Dr. Veekshita is originally from Mysore, and she's done her schooling in Mysore and her graduation from Father Mueller's College, Mangalore. She served a number of patients in her career, and she is always looking for ways to improve her practice. She's working at a senior consultant in holistic homeopathy, Anandapur, and she specializes in treating thyroid patients. If you speak to Veekshita's existence, you realize that she is highly successful in treating thyroid and other issues just from the patient testimonials. She has many happy patients. And what this webinar will tell us is, why Dr. Veekshita is so successful in her treatment. And let's find out. So the stage is yours, Dr. Veekshita. Over to you.
Hello. Good evening, everybody. I hope everyone can hear me. Hello. Yeah, so let me start with the webinar.
We can hear you.
Let me start with the webinar. So today we are going to deal with the thyroid, mainly the symptoms of thyroid, symptoms and problems of thyroid. So let's go through a brief, completely in detail about thyroid. How does thyroid work and what does thyroid do in our body and what all happens in our body? Okay, first let's go for the thyroid introduction. Okay, now let's see where the thyroid is located. So can you see a picture over here? Here I'll show you where is thyroid located. Thyroid is located in our neck. It's just in front of the windpipe. It's called as trachea. So it's in a butterfly shaped of organ. So it has two wings and the connecting place, isthmus it's called as. So thyroid is in front of the windpipe. So in our body, it weighs around 15 to 20 grams of weight. Okay, and its main function is, as everyone knows, it releases T3, T4. The main two hormones which it releases in our body is T3, T4, which is called as, T4 is called as thyroxine, and T3 is called as triiodothyronine. Okay, and one more thing what I have to tell you is, thyroid has two types of cells, that is follicular cells and parafollicular cells. See, the follicular cells of thyroid release T3 and T4. The parafollicular cells release calcitonin. So usually we all mainly discuss about T3 and T4, that is thyroxine and triiodothyronine. No one mostly discusses about calcitonin. But in fact, calcitonin is also very important hormone in our body. I think calcitonin is a self-explanatory. Calcitonin, it explains calcium. So it is the calcium levels in our bones. It helps in the improvement of the calcium levels of our bones, so bone growth, all those things. So if any problem in decrease in calcitonin levels, there'll be people will, have you heard, you people even might have heard about dwarfism, dwarf people or short stature people. Yeah, this calcitonin is also responsible for the growth of the height and growth of all those things. So, but today we'll be mainly concentrating on thyroxine and triiodothyronine, T3 and T4. These are what we are going to concentrate. Okay. So first to get into the abnormalities, before we go into that, let's go for the mechanism of thyroid. So how is the thyroid hormones released in our body? So that is a main thing which we'll start knowing it. So there are two glands which are responsible for the release of thyroid hormones. First, there is hypothalamus, which is located in the brain, which releases thyrotropin-releasing hormone. This thyrotropin-releasing hormone goes to pituitary gland, which stimulates pituitary gland to release thyroid-stimulating hormone. Thyroid stimulating, why I'm explaining this mechanism is because when we see in our blood reports, we mostly see TSH, T3, T4. So we have to know what are these. If we know what are these, we'll get a better idea about what is knowing the abnormalities of thyroid and all. So hypothalamus is another endocrine gland which is located in the brain. It releases thyrotropin releasing hormone, which stimulates pituitary gland. Pituitary gland is also located in the brain, just below the hypothalamus. So it stimulates pituitary gland to produce TSH. So TSH is the one hormone which goes to thyroid and combines with iodine. I think you people can understand what is iodine. iodine, where do we get from iodine in our body? Iodine is something which we get from our diet intake. So this thyroid stimulating hormone combines with iodine and helps in the release of T3, T4. So this is the mechanism of the how the T3, T4 are released. Okay, there's one more important point which I have to mention in this, that is the role of pituitary gland. So the pituitary gland plays a very vital role in our body. Pituitary gland actually monitors the levels of T3, T4 in our body. So in the bloodstream, if there is excess of T3, T4, what does pituitary gland do? Pituitary gland monitors the T3, T4 levels and says and stops releasing TSH if there's excess of T3, T4 hormone. If there is decrease in T3, T4 hormones, what does pituitary gland do? Pituitary gland stimulates, it releases. Hello? Yeah. So, if at all, if there's in the bloodstream, if there is excessive of T3, T4 hormone, there will be release of the pituitary gland will monitor the bloodstream T3, T4 level and will help you to release more TSH. If there is less excessive T3, T4 hormones, then pituitary gland will make sure it releases TSH, less TSH levels. Why I'm explaining this negative feedback? This is called as a negative feedback. What pituitary gland plays vital role in our body. Why I'm explaining this is, usually when you see the blood reports, we always notice there's excessive T3, T4 hormones, but there will be low TSH levels. So this is the reason why I have explained this. Okay, this will be, see in this once again, I'll explain you what is abnormalities of thyroid also in this. So the abnormalities, there are two main abnormalities of thyroid, that is hyperthyroidism and hypothyroid. These are the main things which are actually causing in our body, that is hyper and hypo. So what is hyperthyroidism? Hyperthyroidism is increase in T3, T4 levels in our body and there'll be a decrease in TSH levels. So you got it why I said that, because if there's increase in T3, T4 levels in our body, then it is hyperthyroidism. But due to increase of T3, T4 levels, the pituitary releases less TSH levels. So there will be less low TSH levels. So this is called as hyperthyroidism. Next it is hypothyroidism. Hypothyroidism is where there will be decrease in T3, T4 hormones and there will be increase in TSH levels. So whenever we see the reports or whenever we diagnose thyroid problems, we mainly see TSH levels. If there is increase in TSH levels, we decide it's an hypothyroidism. But there's decrease in TSH levels, we decide it as hyperthyroidism. So these are the two main abnormalities which we observe in thyroid problem. But there are various causes for a thyroid problem like hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism. Hyperthyroidism, it is high levels of T3, T4 levels and less TSH levels. When thyroid makes too much thyroid hormone, your body uses NH. Okay, these are the symptoms. These are the two main abnormalities, hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism. How does it cause? What are the different symptoms of hyper and hypo separately? I will discuss it later. So now we'll go for the causes of the thyroid disease. So mostly thyroid disease are what I've observed in my experience, mostly thyroid cases or thyroid diseases are caused in patients who have high stress levels and mainly lifestyle disorders. These are the main thing which I've observed. And one more thing is hereditary. So let's discuss in detail. First is autoimmune condition, what we have. What is the main cause? Autoimmune condition is something where your own immune system attacks your own thyroid. So your own immune system will attack your thyroid gland. So what happens because of that, there will be swelling of the thyroid, there will be increase in thyroid gland, which leads to hypothyroidism or hyperthyroidism. Hypothyroidism, that will be called as Hashimoto's thyroiditis, or hyperthyroidism will be called as Graves' disease. Next is hereditary condition. Hereditary means if your parents have thyroid problem or your mother, father, your aunt, uncle, your paternal parents or your maternal parents or your grandfather, grandmother. So that also can lead to thyroid problem. Then inflammation of the thyroid. Inflammation of the thyroid due to any infections, viral infection, bacteria, that also can lead to hypo and hyperthyroidism. Next, the birth control pills. Birth control pills in the females mainly. Birth control pills actually affect thyroid very well because those are the hormones which cause an imbalance in our body. The birth control pills are hormonal pills which we take on intake of that. It causes imbalance in the body and lead to thyroid problem because thyroid releases hormones. So there will be an imbalance. Then next, stress. Stress is the main factor which is running now. Stress, people have a lot of stress in their lifestyle and heavy tensions. Usually females think a lot. Because of that, there'll be an abnormalities in the thyroid. Next, let's go to the next, iodine deficiency or excess. That is the food what we take. So if we have, you might have heard people who have thyroid, they'll usually ask you to take iodized salt. That is, if there's decrease in iodine content, then there will be decrease in T3, T4 hormones. If there is iodine intake is more, iodine intake is proper, then there'll be a normal thyroid function. So you should always make sure you take the proper iodized salt if you have hypothyroiditis. Okay. And then the postpartum thyroiditis. Postpartum thyroiditis is nothing but pregnancy. After pregnancy, what thyroid problems do you have? I think usually during pregnancy, the baby will be in need of thyroid hormones. So due to that, the mothers will have insufficient production of thyroid hormones because they have to compensate both the mother and the baby. So because of that, after the delivery, the mother will be suffering from thyroiditis. And one more next thing is, this is the testis, tumors of ovaries and the testis. This is another cause. People will always be having a doubt, like, why does the testis and ovaries cause a hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism? Yes, because the testis and ovaries in males, testis and females ovaries, they release hormones which are very necessary for our body. So if there's any problem, abnormality or any tumors in the testis and ovaries, what happens? There'll be abnormality in the hormone levels in the body. So which leads to thyroid problems. So the ovaries or testis is always connected to the thyroid of a body, in our body. That's why people usually most of them get hysterectomy done. Already delivery is over, the baby is over, we have got the baby, so we get the hysterectomy done. But they don't know that after hysterectomy, there are chances of getting thyroid, hyperthyroidism. That is the main thing which people should take care. That's why we don't encourage people to get hysterectomy done easily. So we let the treatment, we can cure the any problems in the uterus through medicines. Next comes the benign tumors of thyroid or pituitary gland. I have mentioned in the mechanism of the thyroid, how the pituitary gland affects the thyroid. So any tumors in the pituitary gland or thyroid can also lead to hypo and hyperthyroidism. So these are the causes, like what we have read. But main causes, what according to present lifestyle, is the stress, one thing. Then the intake food, iodine deficiency, or people right now go for a lot of junk foods, cauliflower, gobi manchuri, and cabbage. Cabbage instead of cauliflower, local people, outside food, they use cabbage also. So those two are the main boycotters. They hinder the iodine intake in the thyroid. So those two are also responsible for the, they also a thyroid problem. Mostly, so that's why we always say whenever we people who have thyroid problems, stop having cabbage and cauliflower because they stop the action of the thyroid. So those two are not good for the patients who have decreased thyroid hormones. Okay, these are the causes. What are the causes? Autoimmune, hereditary conditions, inflammation of thyroid, birth control pills, stress. And in the birth control pills, I have to also mention one more thing. We girls mainly use pills to postpone their menses and delay their menses. That is also hormonal pills which will cause the thyroid abnormalities. So make sure you avoid those postponing of menses or preponing of menses. Okay, so then the iodine deficiency, food intake, and postpartum thyroiditis, tumors of ovaries. Ovaries are very much connected to thyroid, and tumors of pituitary gland and thyroid also. Okay, the next what we go is, who is affected by thyroiditis? Who most commonly the thyroid, who the people of 40s to 50s, those people will be affected, usually according to the textbook terms. But right now, at present condition, what I have seen in my experiences, 30s is the age people are starting getting. And I have even have a patient of 19 years old also and 20 years old also. So due to the stress levels, due to the lifestyle disorders, due to the food intake, all the junk food. So people are getting thyroid abnormalities at very early age. So that is one thing. And mostly it is mainly affected to the women. The females are mainly affected, because once again, that includes the birth control pills, postponement of menses. So all these things. Next, now main thing, what does the thyroid do? Many of them will be having the doubt, what does T3, T4 do in our body? Okay, now I have to tell you, T3, T4 plays a very vital role in our body. T3, T4 are the main hormones. What it does is, it converts the food what we take. So it converts the food what we take into energy. So whatever food we take, it converts into energy. It goes to each and every cell. That is called as metabolization. So it helps in the metabolization of the food what we take into energy. So T3, T4 hormone, it goes to each and every cell in our body, and it whatever food it helps the food what we take to reach to every cell and produces energy. So by this I can do, T3, T4 makes our body to work properly, correctly, actively. So T3, T4 is necessary for each and every organ in our body to work properly. Okay, so this is called as metabolization. It increases the heat in our body because of metabolization. Metabolization always increases the heat in the body. So this is T3, T4, the main mechanism is it does metabolization. So now we'll see in each organ, what does T3, T4 do? So first we'll go to the heart. Heart is a very important organ. So we'll go to the heart. What does the heart's function is? Heart's function is to have a proper normal heartbeat. Okay, what does T3, T4 do? For the proper normal heartbeat, beta receptors are the one which are responsible for the T3, T4 to, heartbeat. For a heart to beat normally, beta receptors are the one which are necessary for a heart to beat normally. Okay, what does T3, T4 do? T3, T4, it goes to the beta receptors and activates beta receptors and makes the heart beat properly, normally. So if there is any increase in T3, T4 levels, what happens? The heart beats faster. That is not good for any heart. So when it beats faster, what will happen? There will be chances of atrial fibrillations and all those things. So when there is decreased T3, T4 levels, what happens? The heartbeat slows up. The heart becomes very slow. The heart becomes late. So what happens if then at that time the heart, the supply of blood from the heart becomes slower. So both the ways it is dangerous. So proper amount of T3, T4 levels are necessary for the heart. Next important organs are lungs. Lungs are also responsible for the breathing. It takes in the oxygenated air and leaves out the carbon dioxide. So what does T3, T4 do is, it helps the lung cells to properly take the oxygen from the air and release the carbon dioxide in the air. So if there's any decrease in T3, T4 levels, then there will be decrease in the breathing capacity. So what does the person who is affected by decrease in T3, T4 levels do? He'll have to take long gasps of air. He'll take a lot deep, he has to take deep breath because of the slow action of the lungs. If there is increase in T3, T4 levels, what happens to the lungs? There'll be an increase in action. So what happens? The patient gasps air fastly. So what we call this as fast breath. It's also called in medically tachycardia. So the patient starts breathing. That is the reason. So both is not very correct. If the proper appropriate amount of T3, T4 levels are very much necessary for lungs. Next, we go to the muscles, skeletal muscles. See the biceps, the triceps, the muscles, what we develop. So T3, T4 hormones are very much necessary for developing a healthy muscle. It helps the cells to give proteins. So proteins are necessary for the development of muscles. So if anyone wants to develop proper T3, T4, you usually use growth hormones you take in the sports person. And T3, T4 is again responsible for that also. If at all there is excessive T3, T4, the person will have very strong muscle. They'll be very active and they'll be very restless. If there is decrease in T3, T4 levels, the person muscles will be very weak. And they'll not be very quick in action. It's all because of the abnormality of T3, T4 levels. Okay, next one thing, main thing. It is a metabolization. See, now what I had explained to you, the food what we take, T3, T4 converts the food what we take into energy. That is what I have told you, the main action of the T3, T4. What it does, it converts the food what we take into energy. So in this, if at all there is any decrease in T3, T4 level, what happens to the food we take in? So the food what we take in gets converted to fat. So if there's any decrease in T3, T4 levels, then the whatever food we take in, it gets converted into fat. So this fat goes and settles in all the parts of the body. So that is how patients with low T3, T4 levels, hypothyroidic patients, they have become very fat because they increase inappropriate fat and they become weight, and within months they increase in weight. So that is it. And if there is increase in T3, T4 hormones, there will be fast anabolization. That is the fast metabolization. So what will happen? There will be increase in activity. They'll require more amount of food. How much of a food you give, they'll be, some people you have observed, they'll eat every 2 hours, but they'll never become fat. This is one way which helps them, their body constitution, which where the T3, T4 hormones help them in increase in metabolization. So this is the main reason for the increase in the weight and increase in the weight. People will always have a doubt why, due to thyroid problems, we have high weight increase or decrease in weight, all these things. And if you increase in weight or what is the problem, all those things is because of the metabolization, what happens. Next, growth during the childhood. Usually children, during the children, in the kids, if there's any abnormality in thyroid problem, there'll be decrease in the height, there'll be decrease in the weight, there'll be decrease, the bone growth, as I told you, calcitonin is also released by thyroid hormone. So all these are responsible for the children height growth. So if there is any decrease or abnormality in the height growth, then there's a problem in the thyroid. We have to always go for checking the thyroid hormones also. If there's any abnormality, if you correct the abnormality, if the person's weight height is low or the person's weight is low, by correcting the thyroid, there are chances of increasing the height and weight. That is mainly in the children. Okay. Next comes the central nervous brain. Main thing is the brain. Brain also, T3, T4 have a main action on the brain. So usually people with high T3, T4, they are very impulsive. They are very restless because the brain cells, what does the brain do? It actually makes sure you properly work whatever duties you have in a day. So if there is increase in T3, T4 levels, what happens? You become very restless. You tend to do works, many works. You tend to, without getting tired, you tend to do continuously many works, very restless. They'll be on the tip of the toes. That is because of excessive people who have hyperthyroiditis will do that. People who have hypothyroidism, they'll be very lazy. They'll be very lost in thoughts. They'll be in memory. There'll be memory loss. They'll be very lethargy, sluggish, lazy people. We usually complain, why are you so lazy? Why are you so low? It's mainly you will have to check for hypothyroiditis or anything. It causes the sluggishness of brain and laziness of the brain. In central nervous system, brain, that is, there's one more thing, emotions factor. So thyroid also has a very great impact on the emotion factor. If there's excessive T3, T4, emotions, they'll react, they're very impulsive. They react easily to the commands what you do. If you hurt someone, they easily cry off. If you scold, they easily react. That is a hyper. If there is a hypo, there is decrease in T3, T4 level. What they become, they go into depression. They go into depression. They go into sad mode, depressed, despair. So all those things. So it also has a brain fact and the great impact on the emotional factor of the brain. So these are the brief, what does it do in our body? I think you people have got it. It mainly affects the metabolization of each and every cell in our body. So that is how T3, T4 is a very necessary hormone in our body. It is like just a fuel for an engine. That way, it's a fuel for our body. Okay. Next, symptoms. So I think by this, you would have known what are the symptoms of hypo and hyperthyroidism. But I'll tell you one thing. Usually, hypothyroidism, what it is, they feel tired because they'll be very fat and they'll be very lazy. Then they'll have neuralgic problems like numbness, tingling in your hands, and their GIT will also be very slow. So they'll have constipation. They won't have proper active GIT. They'll be very low gas, toilet will not go properly and all those things. They'll gain weight, abnormal fat deposition because of decrease in T3, T4 hormones. Then soreness of the skin, your skin will become very weak, and you'll have abnormal cholesterol levels, you'll have depression, feeling depressed, and because of the fat law, you cannot tolerate the cold temperature, and the coarse skin will be very weak, and you'll also have decrease in sexual interest. That is also due to hypothyroidism, and frequent and heavy menstrual thyroid has, as I mentioned, thyroid and uterus, both are very much connected. If any problem in thyroid or any problem in uterus, there will be hormonal imbalance in the body, which affect each other. So you should always make sure thyroid people have a proper menses cycle, or it means that people who have thyroid, they have to have a proper testis function. Okay. The semen count and all those things. Then in the face, you observe this drooping because hypothyroidism, there'll be lethargic, laziness. So the muscles and all will be very weak. So there'll be drooping of eyelids, puffiness in the eyes and face. Then your voice will become lower and hoarser. Your voice will become lower and hoarser. It's because thyroid is located in the neck. It's located in front of the windpipe. So whenever there is increase in the thyroid area or gland, it affects the windpipe, which is located behind. So you'll have your voice hoarseness of your voice, or you'll have a hawking sensation. You always feel that is also due to thyroid and brain forgetfulness, brain fog. They'll be lazy and all in hypothyroidism. Next is the hyperthyroidism. Increase in appetite. They crave for food a lot. Every 2 hours they need food because there'll be a lot of metabolization, very heavy metabolization. So they'll crave for what, but they'll be very thin also. They won't increase in weight. Then there'll be nervousness, restlessness. They'll be very restless. They'll be in their mind, it will be always running. What to do next? It's over all the works. They'll finish all the works within some time, and they'll be craving for some other works. And they'll have inability to concentrate. They'll not be able to concentrate for a long time because they'll be having running of thoughts in their mind. Now, what is next? What next? Now, all those thoughts, because of that, they'll be inability to concentrate. They'll have weakness. They will have weakness because so many works they do. So because of that, they'll have slightly weakness, but they'll be strong. They'll never say no for the works, but still they'll have the weakness and irregular heartbeat because of the increase. Then difficulty in sleeping because they'll be always on the tip of the toes. Next what? So because of that, they'll not have a proper sleep. In the sleep also, they'll have all the dreams of the activities or day-to-day activities and all. Then hair will become weak because of the loss of this thing. Itching, skin problems, hair loss, nausea. Hair loss is the main thing. People will find out thyroid problems only due to hair loss because people are very much concerned about their hair and all those things. Then nausea, vomiting, then breast development in the men. So hyperthyroidism causes breast development in the men because the testis hormonal imbalance, which leads to the development of death. Then dizziness, shortness of breath, loss of consciousness, fast and irregular heartbeat. So these are all the symptoms of hyperthyroidism. Okay, so now I have told you in everything in brief, that is what is hypothyroidism and what is hyperthyroidism. So everyone know, I think everyone have understood what is hypothyroidism and what is hyperthyroidism. So now we'll go to the aspect of what homeopathy does in hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism. So that is the main thing, homeopathic treatment in thyroid problems. First thing, thyroid problems can be completely cured by homeopathic treatment. That because many of them have a wrong this thing that if we get thyroid, we have to take lifelong treatment. That is a thing which is spread in all the people. It's nothing like that. Thyroid problems can be completely cured by homeopathic treatment. Okay, how does homeopathy treat the patients, thyroid patients? Homeopathy, first of all, generally, not only in thyroid patients, generally homeopathy treats a condition or a disease based on their emotional distress and frustration. And these which emotional distress or frustration which affects the or affects our vital force or the immune system, what we say, this emotional distress or frustration or the other causes, whichever affects our vital force, that is immune system, it considers all those things and then gives a medicine which is individual for each and every. Each and every person will have a different remedies. Okay, for example, I'll explain you in a little detail. See, there will be a group of people, 5 people having thyroid problem. But when you go to a normal conventional treatment, if you go to a, they'll always be prescribed with a different dosage of the same medicine. At the same time, if you go to a homeopath doctor, all the 5 persons will be prescribed with a different medicine. That is because we consider each and every person's personality, character and emotional distress, what emotional problem has caused. That is the stress we mentioned, right? Stress, what stress? Some people some people develop thyroid because they have lost their near ones. Some people develop thyroid because they have a lot of heavy works. They're not able to tolerate. Some people have financial problems. So we consider those causes, that is the emotional distress and frustration. We consider those causes and then give a medicine on basis of that. So that is the reason why each and every 5, in the 5 people, each and every person will have a different remedy. So that is called as individual constitution. That is each and every individually we can connect to the patients. Individually we connect to the patient and then give medicine. That is how it's homeopathy is different from the conventional treatment. We personally take the characteristic of the person. We get to know the emotional distress of the patient and then go. Yeah, and one more thing, by what our medicines do. Our medicine stimulates its body's own healing power. Like it stimulates our vital force, our immunity, our own healing power. Usually we know that our body can heal some things without any medicine. Like if we get an injury, our body can heal itself. So that is how the homeopathy works. Our homeopathy immunity or healing power, it can heal on its. So these medicines, homeomedicines, help us to heal in our own way. I'll explain you in a case. Okay, I'll just take a small case. It's 7:40, but just for 5 minutes. See, I have got a girl, a female, whose age is of 23 years. She had come to me in 15 June 2020. The patient came with a complaint of weight gain. And at that time, she was of 70 kgs and she had irregular periods. She didn't have menses and time. Since 1 year, she was having this problem and her TSH level, thyroid stimulating hormones, was 12.99 and she was taking 88 mcg Thyronol. So personality, patient is very jovial and easygoing person. Patient's mother's, this started because as soon as the patient's mother passed away 3 years back. Since then, patients was very, very much tense. She was lost. She was very hurt and she was in very despair. So since then, she started developing this thyroid problem. So she started homeopathic medicine since 15 June 2020. So she started taking our medicines. We gave medicines based on the patient's mother passed away because of this depressed or despair. On basis of that, we started giving medicine. Now we have tapered the in English medicine, allopath medicine, from 88 mcg to 5 mcg, and she her thyroid hormones are very much normal. If you want, I can tell you the report, show you the reports also. So these are the reports. Her levels were 12.99. It's a bit blurred, but you can see 12.99. That was in the year 23 Jan 2021, this year starting January, and now at present now it's what is the date, 12th October 2021, now her 3.63 levels. So you can 100% cure thyroid abnormalities. Okay, hope you people, all of you, have understood about thyroid and thyroid abnormalities. And if any mistakes, any questions, you can ask me.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
I have one doubt. Is stem cells therapy is available to cure the thyroid problems? Stem cells, complete cure.
Stem cell, like what, for in the babies or what you're asking? How?
Actually, nowadays babies stem cells are stored. If any abnormalities in the future, the stored stem cells can replace the any organ. Is it true or false?
See, that is true in cancerous and bone marrow, all the those conditions, not in the thyroid conditions.
Okay, ma'am. I have another doubt. You said that if stress is the triggering factor, you can counsel the patient and give the treatment according to that patient, but what type of medicines give to the patient? For example, in that case, you give the patient name, 23 years a patient, mother passed away 3 years back, but how can you give the treatment in this case? What type of medications?
See, what do we do is we give a medicine, maybe like mother passed away, that is the main triggering factor. She has got hurt by the loss of closed ones. So we give medicine on basis of loss of closed ones. So on basis of that, when we give the medicine,
means like antidepressants.
No, we don't give antidepressants, not that way. We give, okay. See, there are few medicines which cure the cause, that is the loss of closed ones. Because of that, people get some complaints, thyroid problems or some other. So on basis of that, we give medicine. It's not antidepressants or anything. We don't use those things.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Another doubt. Nowadays, PCOD problem is the majorly we can see. Is thyroid gland is plays major role? I mean, generally, estrogens and progesterones can play imbalances. But thyroid is also plays the major role. Which one is major?
You cannot say which one is major. Everything will have its own role. Everything play equally.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay.
So, yeah, thanks a lot, Dr. Vichita. Maybe you can stop presenting. So, I think...
Okay.
Stop presenting from your side so that...
One second.
We can have a... All right, so I think it's a great explanation by Dr. Vichita about thyroid as well as, you know, the homeopathy treatment. So we should be really thankful to Dr. Vichita. So let us give a big round of applause to Dr. Vichita. I think I don't see anybody on the video, but hopefully everybody's applauding. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, thank you so much.
So now I think there were a couple of questions already. So let's go to a few more questions. I think we have some more time.
Okay.
I think, yeah. Who wants to ask the next question?
Hello. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Ma'am, can you just tell the hyperthyroidism levels and hypothyroidism levels, that is the T3 and T4 levels, and okay, what are normal levels?
Okay, I'll tell you. Usually it is an international unit. It depends on the different differs in each lab. I mean, Usually it is like T3 levels, T4 levels is 5 to 12 mcg, and T3 levels is 0.8 to like 4. Hello? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, see, T4 levels is 5 to 12 mcg.
Okay, ma'am.
And T3 levels is 100 to 200, can go till 200. And TSH levels, thyroid stimulating hormone levels will be below 4, or in some labs even they say below 5 also. But it is very good to be below 4 according to.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
So one of the things that it was great to know that to treat thyroid using homeopathy, you don't have to take the medicine continuously, other methods of treatment.
Yeah.
Here, I think they treat and completely cure, and then no more medicine. I think that's what I understand. Is that right, Dr. Vikshita?
Yeah. You treat and then we taper the dose. If they are taking any other system, other medicines, we taper the dose and then we stop them from those medicines, right. And then we completely stop our treatment also, and they can be free from everything. We can cure them completely.
Also, the emotional situation of the patient is also taken into consideration.
Yes, yes.
So that is a big thing. In fact, instead of treating everyone the same dose or same medicine, they consider different factors, and that's how it works. So it's great to know that.
Actually, that's the greatness of.
Who wants to do? So maybe I can ask you, how did you come to this? Homeopathy. what weight made you to decide? Any particular? You had a mentor or a teacher?
I had special a friend person actually.
Guided you.
I had a friend. My friend actually guided me. She is also a homeopath. We both joined together. She was the one. Actually, I was interested in medicine, so I was actually going for the dental part. She actually motivated me, telling me about homeopathy. She just told me dental is only, you deal with only mouth or teeth. If you come to homeopathy, you can deal with everything. So that's when I chose to.
Right. Yeah, dental is mainly about the teeth and probably. Yeah.
I mean, not only that, she told many other things also. But that was impressive.
But you get to help the whole health, improve the whole health of the people.
Yeah.
So, happy to hear that. So, anyone else?
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, ma'am. Ma'am, actually, thyroid is actually a lifestyle disorder nowadays, actually.
Yeah.
Even if it is treated completely, there are chances of reoccurring, ma'am.
See, I'll give you an example. If you get hurt and fall, we'll cure you. We'll treat you. Once again, if you get hurt and fall, once again you'll have an injury, right? The same way, if you have stress and if you have this lifestyle disorder together, you will have this thyroid disorder. If we cure and give you, and once again, if you get exposed to the stress and lifestyle disorder, once again you will get.
Okay.
So you have to.
Yeah, maybe.
You should have everything in balance.
Maybe doctor,
you should never excess or anything.
Right, yeah.
You should never go for.
Doctor, would be great if you can. Yeah, if you can summarize the lifestyle habits that we should have to at least avoid or future occurrences, maybe.
See, that I can tell you. Lifestyle habits is main thing which leads to many complaints, not only thyroid, diabetes, hypertension, everything. So main thing is we take stress, mainly stress, too much of stress. So for small complaints, we have to reduce the tension what we have in our day-to-day. If your parents or your kid is not studying properly, has not taken his breakfast, those small tension also will create a lot of tension. So you have to stop thinking too much. You have to stop, avoid all the stress, first thing. Second thing is food and diet, main thing. See, food, you know, you have to take in everything in limits, everything balanced, everything in control. You shouldn't take junk food. I'm not saying no to junk food, but you have to take in a proper plan, controlled junk food, like monthly once is also very high actually. You have to take monthly 2 months, 2 months once, that is enough. Junk food is not very much necessary. You can, and if you want to have anything tasty like junk food, you have to prepare it in your home only, first of all. That is the best way to avoid junk food. So diet, food and diet is main thing which you have to notice, especially gobi manchuri and pani puri, all those things you have to avoid. That is the main factor for the thyroid, diabetes, cholesterol abnormalities, everything. So main thing, whatever you want to eat, gobi manchuri or anything, make it in your house. That won't cause any thyroid problems. Okay?
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
You mentioned about stress also. So I suppose meditation is something that is going to help, I mean, avoid stress. So do you recommend?
I recommend like yoga, meditation, exercise very much for each and every patient of whoever comes. If you have starting levels of thyroid, I mean, initial stages, light 1.1 level or two levels of increase in thyroid hormones, you can cure it naturally without the help of any medicines by just doing exercises, yoga, and following proper diet. That I have experienced, I have done, and it's very much proved also. You can cure yourself by following healthy diet and exercises. Exercises is very mandatory for any person. Though person is thin or fat, exercises is very much necessary. Meditation, exercise.
So doctor, is there any particular method of meditation do you follow, or do you recommend any particular ones?
No, usually what I do, no, I mean not particular type of meditation. I usually tell my patients, yeah, whenever they do meditation, make sure you concentrate on your thyroid, like take a deep breath, concentrate. So your meditation improves the blood circulation to your thyroid, which may self-cure it. When you do the meditation, you usually, there's a...
Okay, so what you're saying is that while you're sitting and closing your eyes and everything, just give an attention to the thyroid and thinking that it is going, it's getting reduced, maybe.
Yes. Because usually it's going away. In meditation, there's a separate...
And that produces the tension.
Yeah. That is the one thing. That is what I usually suggest my patients. For 5 minutes, concentrate on your thyroid and concentrate on your personal life. That is more than enough for your relaxation.
Ma'am?
Yeah?
I have another doubt.
Any particular time? Yeah, Lakshmi. Yes.
You said that cabbage and cauliflower may be responsible for the causing thyroid problems. What is the mechanism? Means which part of the physiology may be affected? I mean, you said mechanism.
Thyroid.
Hypothalamus releases TRH, pituitary gland, you said like that, no? So whenever we take cabbage and cauliflower, I mean, mechanism, exact at what hormone it blocks and causes thyroid problems.
It doesn't affect hypothalamus or pituitary. Goitrogens directly affect the thyroid gland. That is the iodine intake, that mechanism it affects. I haven't actually told you in detail how the TSH combines with iodine and forms T3, T4. So this, the goitrogens, we call this cauliflower, cabbage, soya beans, all these as goitrogens. These affect the thyroid gland, directly only the thyroid gland, which the mechanism in the thyroid gland. So which inhibits, I mean, hinders the release of T3, T4.
Okay, ma'am, thank you.
So you are recommending, like those who are having thyroid, you are recommending to avoid the use of these vegetables. Is that true, or?
Yeah.
Or just limit?
Hypothyroidism, no, avoid the use of cauliflower and cabbage, soya beans.
For hypothyroidism.
Yeah.
Until it is cured, I guess. Until it is cured.
Until it is cured. Yeah.
Okay. Because otherwise, generally, for healthy lifestyle, these vegetables are
necessary.
Right.
Only till your thyroid, if there's any abnormality in thyroid, only these goitrogens affect you. that is cauliflower cabbage affects you. So if your thyroid abnormality is cured, you can have this cauliflower and cabbage. I mean, but in control units, like cauliflower, you can have, in the sense, you cannot go and have daily gobi manchuri. That is not the right thing. You have to have it in a control unit. Monthly once, gobi manchuri, that is enough.
Ma'am?
Yeah.
Apart from this cabbage and cauliflower, there are any foods that to avoid in during the thyroid month?
See, during the thyroid, what I suggest is, I usually tell soya, because most of them don't use soya. Soya, cauliflower, cabbage, and I also suggest them to avoid potato, beetroot, or some of this, because they cause the fatting of patients. Usually, hypothyroid patients become very increase in weight. So by avoiding potato and all those, they can slightly stop that. So that's why, along with that, I also give them a diet, like don't have fat rich foods, don't have all those things for some time.
Okay, ma'am.
Mm.
All right, very good. Anyone else? You're seeing a lot of people out there, but no one is opened their video, so we don't see you. Maybe you can come on video and probably ask a question or two. Priyanka, hello, Priyanka. I think Priyanka is someone I talked to today. Hello, are you there? Any other questions, anyone else? Leela, do you have any question? We have Vishnu here. And also Ranga, I think both of them are from Anandapur only, from your city. So I think it is almost 8 o'clock. It's only 2 minutes, so we should thank a lot, Dr. Deekshita, for a wonderful presentation today. And so we are very proud, Jaldi is very proud to bring such wonderful speakers to improve health of each and every one of you. And we will continue to do that. I'm sure we can bring back again, you know, Dr. Deekshita, maybe in a few weeks or a month or so, so that more people will benefit from her willingness to share the knowledge and helping to cure diseases like thyroid forever. So once again, on behalf of Jaldi and on behalf of all the people that who attended today, big thanks to Dr. Deekshita and the holistic homeopathy clinic at Anandapur, Andhra Pradesh.
Thank you, sir. It's my honor.
Thank you very much. Any last, I'm sorry.
Thank you. It's my honor to be a speaker and present the case also to you. It's my one way of my expression also. Thank you so much for the medium, to be a medium to reach the people.
Thank you, doctor. And you know, jaldi.com, our headquarters is in Kerala and specifically near to Cochin. So you know, please do visit Kerala, and I hope you know, just and hopefully we'll be glad to host you and your family here.
Yeah.
And Kerala is a wonderful place. Let's, you know, just let me also promote the tourism here. It's a tourist destination. So I hope to see you or we come to Anandapur, and we come to Anandapur. Hope to see you also soon.
Yeah.
So all the very best to, you know, you and your family, your clinic.
Thank you. Thanks once again.
We'll end the presentation today. Okay. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.